good suspension setup. So, our number one tip to make sure to have the best performance out of our 4060 is to have a good suspension setup for you and how you ride. The good news here is, although suspension is a complex subject, with a good baseline for your fork setup and your shock setup is pretty simple to get it. So, let's get started. There is three key figures to really take in account. First of all, the SAG. This is how much the shock or the fork is compressing while you are on the bike. Compression damping. This is the rate of how much the shock is compressing. Rebound damping. This controls the rate of how much the fork extends after compression. As each model of fork and shock use slightly different technology, please also refer to the manufacturer's manual which is delivered with your bike, but also directly on their website, where they might have a couple of tricks for you as well. All the points that we're gonna talk to through today's video are just a baseline that we're using, but those might differ depending on where you ride. For example, bike park, you would have to have less sag, but more compression. If you ride a little bit more steep trail, for example, more sag, less rebound. So this is really up to you and where you ride, as we mentioned before. The best way to find your baseline setup is basically to experiment with setting. Make sure that once you get this baseline setup, you write it down, then you can still experiment with it. But in case if it goes wrong, you can always refer to this one. So, how do I set up my suspension and what tools do I need? Basically quite simple. Shock pump and a ruler. So, the 4060 LT or ST, same for our e-bike, the Z family, have been developed to work between 28 and 30% sag with 65 millimeter shock for the long travel, 62.5 for the model year 22, and 57.5 millimeter stroke for the short travel one. So make sure to have firstly the correct stroke of your shock. To have the exact measure of the sag, 28 or 30%, we've put down a chart below. Make sure to use a proper ruler to have the exact number. For the fork, we generally recommend to start as a base setup with 20% sag. This you can find on all manufacturing websites, but for more precision, you can also scale the sag to your weight, and generally you have a sizing chart directly on the lower hand of the fork. So now that we get the theoretical speech down, let's dig into it, and we're gonna do a baseline setup for our friend Dominic, which is just around the corner here. Hey, salut Dominique.
Salut, tu vas bien?
Ouais, bien. Prêt pour faire un petit baseline setup?
Yes.
Tu peux t'installer.
Make sure all adjustments on the fork are fully open. Attach the shock pump and inflate the air chamber to the recommended air pressure according to your weight, fully kitted. Compress the suspension through at least 50% of its travel by pushing down on the handlebar.
Ouais, parfait.
Slide the O-ring on the fork section down. Without compressing the fork, step off the bike. Measure the distance between the rubber seal and the O-ring. This is your sag measurement figure. Attach the shock pump to the shock valve and inflate the air chamber in order to reach the goal of 30% sag. Make sure all adjustments on the shock are fully open, and any lever in an open position. Pump and compress the suspension 5 times by standing on the bike. Pull the sag indicator O-ring up against the air sleeve. Step off the bike without bouncing. If your shock have a sag indicator, simply refer to it. If your shock doesn't have a sag indicator, measure the distance between the O-ring and the air sleeve seal. This is your sag figure.
Hey, here you go, perfect setup. Enjoy the ride. Ciao. So, back at it with our bike this time equipped with a coil shock. The main difference adjusting the sag between an air shock and a coil shock is on the air shock will increase or decrease the air pressure, and on the coil shock It's basically adjusting the spring according to your weight. As we mentioned on the other video, for the coil shock, if you like a super sensitive feeling on the bike, something really plush and the bike hugging to the ground, that's definitely a good alternative for you. To set up the sag on the coil shock, you will basically use a bumper instead of an O-ring. So just as a baseline, higher spring rate to decrease sag, lower spring rate to increase sag. As simple as it is. To check precisely what spring rate is needed for our bike, please check the chart below and we have exactly the spring rate defined for your weight. So that's it for a quick sag setup video. So just make sure once you have your setup super dialed to write it down. Then in case there is any changes, you can always go back and refer to it. Cheers and enjoy the ride.
One eternity later.
So, now that we get... So...